My name is Dhruvil Pandya. I'm a cerebrovascular specialist specializing in vascular neurology and intervention neurology. I am a medical director of stroke at Northwestern Medicine Delnor Hospitals. I'm the principal investigator of the 3D virtual reality study at Marianjoy. I believe virtual reality can help with stroke recovery. A traditional rehabilitation method works really well, but there are many factors that play a role for better outcomes. So the more tools we can add, it can only result into better outcomes. So technology like virtual reality, what is that doing for us is that it can help us start therapy early while in their hospital or ICU and prolong the therapy once they go home or they're in outpatient settings. So we really believe this will be a big benefit for patients recovering.
Hi, I'm Nick Giovannetti. I'm an occupational therapist at Northwestern Medicine Marianjoy Rehabilitation Hospital. I'm also the clinical program coordinator for the stroke program and a co-investigator for the 3D VR study. So the objective of our study was threefold. We wanted to look at the acceptability of the device, you know, if patients liked it, the tolerability of the device, if they could handle a session using the virtual reality in rehab, and then we were looking at the functional outcomes of using the device.
We included patients who had either ischemic or hemorrhagic stroke, admitted to our Marianjoy Rehabilitation Hospital, and had upper extremity weakness. We enrolled a total of 20 patients with average age of 66, 60% being male, 80% had ischemic stroke. We had three separate aims for the study. The first aim was to look at acceptability of the device. We hypothesized that people will accept the device. By defining it as more than 50% completing the study protocol, which was 30 minutes sessions for a total of 6 sessions, and more than 50% ranking in every score of more than 4 in the 7-point Likert scale. And what we found is that majority of the patients completed the study without any side effects from the device. From those who've completed study and we have data for, what we found is the average score on the Likert scale was around 5.3. Our second aim was to look at the tolerability of the device, and we use a simulator sickness questionnaires to assess that. And what we found is none of the patients reported any significant symptoms associated with the device. Actually, interestingly, some of them who came for the study were complaining of symptoms of fatigue and tiredness actually had improvement in the symptoms after they completed their study protocol.
During our sessions, the patients would be wearing a head-mounted virtual reality device like this one. They're able to kind of be immersed in a virtual environment, and the sensors that they're wearing all over their body will kind of give them feedback as to what they're doing, and they can see their arms moving, their body kind of moving side to side, and kind of how they're interacting with their environment. From a therapist experience, you know, we found that the device was super easy to use, easy to set up, you know, and most importantly, really easy to customize for what we were working on with our patients. You know, we were able to put them in a functional environment, do functional movements that, you know, directly tie to things that they're gonna have to do once they take the device off in order to improve their independence with self-care and ultimately get home. Our patients were very motivated to get in the device, to participate in their therapy sessions. When they're in that device, all that they were seeing and doing was kind of contained there, and you know, they could really see what their arm was doing. They could see the improvements that they were making.
What we learned from our study, that people find this fun. It creates a different environment. It makes therapy joyful. And I think that allowing them to feel that joy and having that mindset can only benefit them from a recovery perspective.
This device and virtual reality in general allows you to get lots of repetitions, and we're able to push our patients a little bit harder than maybe we would be able to during a conventional rehab session. And all those repetitions really drive neuroplasticity, which is what our patients' brains need in order to kind of rewire themselves and start building those connections back up. So hopefully after, you know, we're finishing with this study and learning how, you know, great it can be for our stroke patient population, that we can expand, you know, looking at using the device or using virtual reality with different patient populations.
From the research perspective, our next step is to compare our current clinical data to the historical match cohort and to see whether this clinically made any differences compared to a traditional rehabilitation. Depending on the results of that study, we would like to take this step ahead to perhaps do a randomized trial to see addition of virtual reality has better outcomes compared to just traditional rehabilitation options.